he was my Christmas present last year, December, and it was the best Christmas present ever. It's just.
Danielle has earned first place 4-H State Awards, and with this 12-year-old's progress has come the gift of Champ. He was a high-quality show horse, but he's an animal that now may have to be put to sleep because of a parasite in his spinal cord.
Because when this germ is in the spinal cord, what it's doing, it's interfering with the message that's being sent from the brain to the muscle. And what you'll see is just this unstableness where the horse is just a little bit wobbly. He sways behind. He's not able to be ridden. He's not able to be shown. You can't ride them. You know, they're not safe to ride, and they don't move well. And he's a liability. Because when you stop and think about a horse that has this, you keep him for a pet for a lifetime, and they may not ever be rideable, but they can still get around. So this sometimes puts us in the position of having to make some hard choices, some difficult choices. And those are dictated by economics, because the economics of keeping a horse for a pet.
You got economics on one side, and then you have her big brown eyes on the other side. And when you look at those two straight up, the brown eyes win.
The disease is called equine protozoomyelocephalitis, or EPM for short, and cases in Indiana are growing.
I've seen some that from the time the disease started, that within 48 hours would be completely paralyzed in the hind quarters.
Doctors say it's important for horse owners to know that this is not transmitted from horse to horse. It's most likely picked up from possum droppings in the fields where they graze.
Doctors use drugs to try to keep the parasite from reproducing and hope it dies a natural death. But 40% of the horses don't improve, and 15% relapse, leaving owners with an expensive investment and disappointment.
Just to have him in our backyard would be nice, rather than putting him down.